Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white, like a good country.
Hard work, work. Hard work, work. Hard work, work.
Up every day.
Hard work, work.
Making music the army way.
Hard work, work.
Heard the bugles in the early morn.
Hard work, work.
Love to hear when they play that horn.
Hard, hard work, work. Hard work, work. Hard work,
training for the ACFT.
Hard work, work.
Better learn how to tuck them knees.
Hard work, work.
Hard work, represent our band.
Hard work, work.
Making music only two sap can.
Hard, hard work, work. Hard work, work. Hard work,
shape, face, spit, shine my shoes.
Hard work, work.
Looking fresh in distinctive blue.
Hard work, work.
Eight buttons and a big red hat.
Hard work,
Mama
work.
Said, would you look at that?
Hard work, work. Hard work, work. Hard work,
hard work to start my day.
Hard work, work.
Hard work. I earn my pay.
Hard work, work.
Olive branches all across the land.
Hard work, work.
Courtesy of the army band.
Hard work, work.
If you've spent any time on the internet in the past several weeks, I'm sure you've seen plenty of people participating in the Don't Rush TikTok challenge. Well, that was the Army Voices bringing you their own rendition of the challenge with a little huah twist. Next up, we will be featuring one of our past performances of a medley of songs from the hit Broadway musical, Hamilton. This song takes you through the harrowing experience that was one of the earliest battles our Army engaged in freedom's defense. Join us as we rap and sing our way through the Battle of Yorktown, followed by a live performance of My Country 'Tis of Thee by the U.S. Army Voices.
The Battle of Yorktown, 1781.
Monsieur Hamilton!
Monsieur Lafayette!
In command where you belong.
You say, no sweat, we're finally in the field, we've had quite a run.
Immigrants.
We get the job done. So what happens if we win?
I go back to France. I bring freedom to my people if I'm given the chance.
We'll be with you when you do.
Go, lead your men.
I'll see you on the other side.
Till we meet again.
I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Hang on just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry. I'm not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot.
Till the world turns upside down. So much it feels more like a memory. This is where it gets me. On my feet, the enemy ahead of me. If this is the end of me, at least I have a friend with me. Weapon in my hand, in command, and my men with me. Then I remember my allies is expecting me. Not only that, my allies is expecting. We gotta go, gotta get the job done. Gotta start a new nation, gotta meet my son. Take the bullets out your gun, the bullets out your gun. We move undercover and we move as one. Through the night, we have one shot to live another day. We cannot let a stray gunshot give us away. We must find a post, seize a moment to stay in it. It's either that or meet the business end of a bayonet. The code word is Rochambeau, dig me?
Rochambeau!
You have your orders now, come and go. And so the American experiment begins. When my friends are scattered to the winds. Lawrence is in South Carolina, redefining bravery.
We'll never be free until we end slavery.
When we finally drive the British away, Lafayette is there waiting
in Chesapeake Bay.
How do we know that this plan would work? We had a spy on the inside, that's right.
I can use money.
And a spy on the British government. I take the measurements, information, and then I smuggle it. To my brother's revolutionary coming in. I run it with the Sons of Liberty, and I am loving it. Against the ruffians, you in the deep now. Somebody's gotta shovel it. Hercules Mulligan, I need no introduction. When you knock me down, I get the hell back up again.
After a week of fighting, a young man in a red coat stands on a parapet.
We lower our guns as he frantically waves a white handkerchief.
And just like that, it's over. We tend to our wounded. We count our dead.
Black and white soldiers wonder alike if this really means freedom.
Not yet.
We negotiate the terms of surrender. I see George Washington smile. We escort them men out of Yorktown. They stagger home, single file. Tens of thousands of people flood the streets. There are screams and church bells ringing. And as our fallen foes retreat, I hear the drinking song they're singing.
The world turned upside down.
Active duty Air Force right after 9/11, where I joined, like, I need to do something for my country now more than ever. Because after the college, I just stopped and got a regular job. But then I saw that and I wanted to go, they put a fire in me to go join again. So I joined the Air Force, went overseas to Japan, got deployed from Japan over there to Qatar, got out, took a year off, and I missed it and came back to it. It's just a part of my life. This is part of my life regardless. I can't let it go. Camaraderie, you know, this is my second family.
For this current mission we're on, we're supporting the Navajo Nation by setting up a field hospital. We're setting up beds in support of Arizona, and just for upcoming COVID patients, so they have a place to get treated. To me, being part of this mission, it means the world, because joining the Army, all I ever wanted to do was help other people, and through the Army and through this mission, I'm doing some meaningful things for the community, and I see that impact, especially here in a rural community that needs the help. So it's very impactful. I've been on multiple missions during my time with during this COVID pandemic. I helped out at St. Mary's Food Bank. I helped out in a lot of rural communities that actually need the help. So it's just not in Phoenix or Mesa or the cities where it's highly populated. A lot of the rural communities, they don't have the same resources as us. And it is really humbling and really amazing experience to go out to these communities, talk to the local people, and actually make a difference and see that difference in that population.
The reason of me serving was my tradition of my family. I'm the only female actually that took the step to join. It's a sense of pride, sense of accomplishment, done things that most people in the United States will never get to do. I enjoy it. It's a challenge every day.
For me, some of my most satisfying experiences in the Army Band are when we really get to make a personal connection with audience members. Oftentimes we come off stage after a show and people want to tell us stories about their daughter who's deployed, or their granddad who served in World War II, or about their own time in service. And I just think it really speaks to the power of music to bring people together and connect them in a way that nothing else can.
Throughout my life, I always wanted my art and my music to mean something more. I don't come from a large military background or a large family, so you can imagine it was quite a shock when I told everyone I was joining the Army and I was going to be in the Army Band. But through the experiences and the performances, we are able to share people's hopes and their dreams and sometimes their pain. And through these experiences and that unity, I've been able to learn and gain a new perspective on what it means to be an American. That we don't just share a past, but together as Americans, we share a future, and that I get to be a part of that future.
Hello, I am Sergeant Major Colin Eaton, Group Leader for the United States Army Band Pershing Zone's Army Voices. It has been my honor and privilege to have had the opportunity to serve the United States Army for the last 21 years. I would like to take this opportunity to say thank you to the United States Army for all that you have provided for me and my family, and for all that you have provided for this great nation.
Generation. from the plains to distant shore, with the gifts that they were given, were determined to leave more. Battles fought together, and acts of conscience fought alone. These are the seeds from which America received. Let me know in my heart when my days are all through. America, America, I gave my best to you. To share, who fear in their hearts that there is no hero there. No, each quiet act of dignity is that which fortifies the soul.
Just watched was made famous by singer-songwriter Nora Jones, and this performance was featuring soloist Sergeant First Class Tracy Labrecque. As we bring our program to a close, we would like you to join members of the United States Army Band in wishing the Army a happy birthday.
Hello, this is Sergeant First Class Brendan Curran with the U.S. Army Band, wanting to wish the Army a happy birthday.
Happy birthday to our United States Army.
Happy birthday, Army.
Happy birthday to the United States Army.
Happy birthday, Army.
Happy 245th birthday to our United States Army.
Happy 245th birthday, U.S. Army.
We would like to dedicate our last song to our nation's greatest fighting force with our rendition of Paul McCartney's Freedom, featuring soloist Sergeant Major Colin Eaton.
This is my right given by God, to live a free life, to live in freedom. I'm talking about freedom. I'm talking about freedom. I will fight for the right. If anyone
tries to take it away, they'll have to answer, 'cause this is my right. I'm talking about freedom. I'm talking about freedom.
I will fight for the right to live in freedom.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all persons are created equal, that they're endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, which among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. I'm talking about
freedom, freedom.
Talking about
freedom. I will fight for the right to live in freedom.
I'm talking about
freedom, freedom,
freedom.
I will fight for the right.
From the American Revolution to today's War on Terror, we honor the proud history and heritage of our United States Army. From all of us at Pershing Zone, we thank you for joining us today in celebrating the Army's 245th birthday. Army strong.
First to fight for the right and to bear the nation's light, and the Army goes rolling along. That's fine.